हेलो हेलो
यस सर।
ओके सो आई थिंक आई एम डिस्कसिंग अबाउट योर डिफरेंट ग्रेडिंग ऑफ बिटुमिन। सो कैन एनीवन से हाउ द ग्रेडिंग ऑफ बिटुमिन इज डिसाइडेड एंड हाउ द ग्रेडिंग ऑफ बिटुमिन इज डन? बिकॉज आई डिस्कस ऑल द एस्पेक्ट व्हाई वी हैव अ नीड टू क्वांटिफाई डिफरेंट ग्रेडिंग ऑफ बिटुमिन। कैन एनीवन से?
सर, जब जिस बीटूमिन का विस्कोसिटी ज्यादा रहेगा उसका वीजी ज्यादा रहेगा,
ओके
और जिस बीटूमिन का विस्कोसिटी कम रहेगा उसको उसका विस्कोसिटी ग्रेडियंट कम रहेगा।
ओके गुड। सो आई थिंक तुम एक स्टेप और आगे चली गई हो, अच्छी बात है। अब काम आसान कर दिए तुम। तो ऑप्शन ए, आई थिंक दिस इज योर VG40। सो इफ आई यूज VG दैट मीन्स यू ऑल फैमिलियर विथ डैट VG, डैट मीन्स VG इज फॉर योर विस्कोसिटी ग्रेडिंग। VG40 डैट मीन्स दिस इज योर 3200, इट इज ऑल्सो रिटेन एज बिकॉज यू नो आई थिंक विस्कोसिटी इज ऑल्सो दिस इज योर काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी एंड द यूनिट ऑफ काइनेमेटिक विस्कोसिटी इज पास। सो बेसिकली VG40 इज ऑल्सो रिटेन एच 3100 पास। सो इट इज यूज इन हाई स्ट्रेस एरिया। सो दिस विटामिन इज यूज इन हाई स्ट्रेस एरिया। High stress area. So basically, its example is at Toll Plaza. So at Toll Plaza we use. You see Toll Plaza or not? I think you all see this Toll Plaza.
Yes sir.
Okay, so this is also a question asked in your examination, that in Toll Plaza we use the bitumen of grade VG40, VG30, VG20, VG10. So you all, because Toll Plaza is basic common thing for your transportation purposes, because at Toll Plaza, you collect the money for a particular road which will be traveled by your vehicle. So basically Toll Plaza is important factor for your highway or for your geometric design. So you all remember this thing, that at Toll Plaza we use bitumen of high viscosity grade. So there VG40 is used. So by heart this point. Next is your VG30. So this is your VG30. So VG30 is also written as 2400. So it is used for your paving application. Basically, it is used for your paving application. That means this grade of bitumen is used for making highway pavement, used for in paving activity or paving application. Using paving application. Next is your VG20. So it is used for also used in paving application in cold climate. So this is C point, and C point is your VG 20. So it is also used in paving application in cold climate. It is not rebbing, it is paving. So I write again. I think it is in a readable form that it is rebbing. P-A-V-I-N-G. So it is also used in paving application in cold climate. So this is another question asked in your examination, that in cold climate, which bitumen you used? So VG 20 is used in our cold region or in cold climate. So you all remember this point, that in cold region we use our VG 20. And last is your, I think, VG 10. VG 10. So it is used for your spray application. So at various places we required bitumen for spray application, so there we used our bitumen VG10 as spray application. So it is used as a spray application. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are all about your bitumen. So I'm discussing what do you mean by bitumen? What are the various application of your bitumen, or where we use our bitumen? Then I say, what are the basic physical property of our bitumen? Then I say, what are the different grades of bitumen? So here we see that, on depending upon the viscosity, we divide our bitumen in different grade, and these are our common grades, or these are our popular grade which would be used during our bitumen or during our pavement construction or during various works of bitumen. So first one is your VG 40, that means viscosity grade 40. Here I also write in poise also. So VG 30, here VG 20, here VG 10, and I also say what are the different use of this viscosity grading bitumen. So is it okay to everyone? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here I just wait. I think, yeah. Is it visual?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this PPT visual?
Sir.
Okay, so you all see here, we start our pavement material as bitumen. So in content part, we have introduction, types, property, and tests on bitumen, and grading of bitumen is also available. So introduction, you all see, it is used in pavement. It is a binding material. Someone is saying, sir, it is binding material. Used in bearing course, primer, patchwork, surface dressing, etc. Bitumen, tar are not same. So I also say that your bitumen and tar are not same, because bitumen is obtained from where we obtain bitumen? Can anyone say from where we obtain bitumen? here it is written that
fractional distillation of.
Okay, so you are crude. Saying fractional distillation of crude oil. You remember these things, fractional distillation of crude oil, and tar is obtained from your destructive distillation of coal or wood. So it is written that bitumen and tar are not same. So it is obvious point, and you all know how our bitumen and tar are different. Next is your bitumen and tar. So black or dark colored solid, basically I say that bitumen is, I saying that in physical property of bitumen, it is black or dark colored solid. Next, it is viscous cementous substance. Bitumen is petroleum product, so it is obvious point, obtained by distillation of crude petroleum or natural available in asphalts. Coal tar byproduct in destructive distillation of coke, coal or wood. So basically this is obtained from your distillation of crude petroleum or crude oil. That means obtained from fractional distillation. Here it is written as, it is not written, but you kept in mind it is obtained from fractional distillation. It is obtained from your destructive distillation. Next, bitumen and tar, excellent binding property, good waterproofing surface. That means it have more assistance against water. Next is your tar, highly temperature susceptible. So I think in bitumen discussion, I say that this is not much temperature susceptible, but here you see your tar is highly temperature susceptible. So you have an option that if, so I think everywhere in this world we construct a road. So where, so it is possible that at various part of world, the temperature is very high. That means the temperature, nature or the condition of temperature or the topographical temperature is very high. So there we use tar. Next, it is a kind of pollutant. So it also generate pollutants. Next is poor adhesion in presence of water. Poor adhesion, that means if water comes in contact with this tar, then tar will easily broke the bond that exists between this aggregate. So it is also obvious point. Next is your bitumen preferred over tar. So we generally use bitumen in the place of tar, but we have not an option available for using our bitumen, then at that place we use tar. And I think also one or two point you know from your side that here we use our tar. So it is okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So just wait.